Live we are. Final sip of coffee. How are you beautiful people doing? Thank you for your patience as ever. Queuing up some old favorite friends and some new people. That is amazing. Thank you for coming on and checking on. We're going to be talking about further ideas, and it's going to surround real estate, property, the key. It's one of the key asset classes, apart from both as an investment level, at just your personal home, lifestyle. A lot hangs around property, status, social proof, all sorts of things. But more importantly, the quality of your living, and can you get it cheap? Can you buy your way into a higher standard of lifestyle through this crazy reset times? Is there a real opportunity? And I'm here to suggest to you that I assess there is indeed a great opportunity for you to lever yourself up. When I say lever yourself up, in fact, you don't have to get very particularly leveraged, but to prepare yourself for making some key decisions. And it's a big decision. In fact, most people that never run a business, the biggest financial decision they make of any variety is the one where they're buying a home. And it's something that some people only do three or four times, and some maybe five times in a lifetime. So it's the big money, and it's when you make the big money is where you make the real things. It doesn't have to be famous saying penny wise and pound foolish. You can overlook, you know, a little bit here, a little bit there, paying a touch more on the small things, a meal, a coffee, whatever, etc. But don't get the financials wrong on big property-based investments, because if you're buying at the top of the market instead of at the bottom of a market, it makes a massive difference in terms of where you end up. Yeah, so look at that reset sniper. This time I'm wearing one that almost fits all over here. He's become a t-shirt salesman. Help. You can order and buy now. It's for a bit of fun because we like the branding getting out there. We know we have fans. You guys have asked for the shirts. It's not my business at all. But we've gone for the highest quality. We don't do it ourselves. The highest quality. That's why they slightly... I said the price for the t-shirt. They said, it's pricey. I said, yeah, but it's the best, thickest cotton. In other words, it's not one of those that's falling apart after 10 washes. So if you want a sniper t-shirt, you know where to get them. The details will be below. Oh, also, by the way, can I all ask you, before we get into this very juicy, very, very real and relevant topic, in reset season, real estate, and I'm hoping that's going to be some super useful tips, and some of you will think about your plans and your ideas and your schemings. You'll move from your amygdala, back of your brain, into the forefront of your rational corporate executive part of your mind, where your warrior, where your sage, where your empathy person, your good Samaritan is, and you will think, how do I best serve myself? Your leader, your leadership zone. You need to get out of the amygdala, get out of the fear and the panic and the mayhem that they're creating. That's the reaction. Remember, problem, reaction, solution. They are trying to provoke a certain reaction. The biggest way you win in this environment is not to give the control structure the reaction they seek. And actually to say, any plandemic-based crisis is actually an opportunity for me, because everyone else is running around like a headless freaking chicken. And you know what? I'm okay. I'm not scared. I see the opportunity. I'm excited. Do you know a great concept just before going on and public speaking and all of that? People used to get this fear. I used to still get that fear. And I'd say the fear is a good thing. Now I'd argue I'm almost not a natural, but a good public speaker. The whole concept of fear or a bit of nerves is just reconstituted excitement. Stuff is going down. Fortunes are lost and made in a hurry during these times. So most things take a long time to happen and are compounded slowly. And you have to sit there and tick along and earn your little salary and save your $50 that you're living within your expenses and put it into something that moves 0.25% a month, and then you save another $50 and it moves. At times like these, all those disciplines in the slow snail periods, the escalator, you know, in the market, they talk about the stock market, it goes up like an escalator and goes down like an elevator. let me just say, the accelerated moments of real preparedness and smart corporate executive execution out of this part of your brain, the forefront, the rational committee of your mind. And as I've said, there's a leader in there. I have avatars for these people, and I suggest you do this. This is some of the things we cover actually in our mindset segment in our own content, by the way. And it's incredibly powerful and extends well beyond trading. Trading is a microcosm of becoming awesome in life generally. And the mindset, the committee of the mind, is a great way. The minute you say, hold on, I'm feeling a little bit nervous and a little bit in fear and a little bit cramped in and cabin fever, and they've got me like a rat in a corner. What to do. And you just big ass breath, proper exercise, workouts, bit of your favorite movie, dance naked in front of the mirror, whatever you have to do. But the key thing is kick yourself back into that mind and say, now that I've got the endorphins and the biological drugs feeling, and I'm my real self, street fighting man, and if you're a woman, a real woman with proper spine and belief and conviction, now I'm going to move into my avatars, and I'm going to call the board meeting of my mind, and I'm going to bring in there Julius Caesar as leader. That's who my avatar is. Grandiose, big, running an empire, smart, not afraid to make a decision. Warrior. I have four out of Marvel comics. How bad is that? Marvel, the ones that also bring us the non-binary. That's terrible. But I used to like him. You know, he had a hammer and he could, and a cape, a red cape, and long blonde hair, which was once my affliction that none of you will believe nowadays in my low maintenance economy cut hairstyle. So, you know, he was sort of a blue-eyed Aryan boy. So I identified with him physically, and he was just muscles. So Thor is my warrior. And then I have the Good Samaritan, the great story about how the rabbis left the broken man in the street and would not touch him. And it was the Samaritan who stopped and nurtured him. You need the Samaritan, you need the person, the carer. This is not soft teddy bear, HR cuddly nonsense. It's showing empathy. It's recognizing not being a psychopath, not being above other people that are below, recognizing that you can assist those around you, those that might be in a lesser situation than you at that given point in time, which might be some of you here, and many of you might be way above there. The point is you have empathy for your fellow man, which is why you load the control structure. These are the things and the aspects of your mind, and we go into that in our mindset in our new course content on a far greater level. But I'm asking you all, get into that state now, because their game is to provoke panic, fear, and actually forwarding on all the memes on WhatsApp about 5G and how they're frying our brains and all of this. You're just helping putting all your other people around you in fear. You're having this thing reiterated like a brain watch. I might be just swinging the watch, the hypnotist watch, and say, look into my eyes, you are so afraid, where are and the point is, absolutely not. It's a gorgeous sunny day outside. I've got a nice rim flow pool to go jump into. And even if you don't, you can jump into your bath. I've got the jungle behind me. I'm very lucky. I'm very fortunate. And so actually are you. You have your health, you have your strength and your vitality. And now it's time to make quality decisions in the elevator-based times. And you spend 99% of the time on the escalator, people. And that's slow going. That requires discipline and patience. Now, you still need discipline and patience, but you also need timing. And if you strike when the iron is hot, you can quantum leap forward where you want to go. If you're a small businessman and you wanted to get really cheap assets, tools, grow, extend beyond, there are going to be opportunities, a wash here. Government will not be able to buy it all. Anyway, so the main thing I was talking about was real estate. But I wanted to also first frame that. And can I ask, we've got 76 likes out of 274. If you know someone who really needs to hear a message that could kick up their standard message, you go share right now. It's quite simple. You find the share button up there and you click it and you share. You share it to your mother, your papa, your uncle, your brother, or your best friend. I'm asking each one of you to share it to one relevant person other. You could have a material effect in changing their life. They can watch it on recording if they don't have time now. Share it to them now. That will be recorded. It'll be on YouTube. YouTube. It's on the right channel this time. We won't have to take it down and do a new link and tweet it out. My dyslexic tendencies have been looked after by the clever people around me. So you will be able to do it. Do them that favor. Hit the like button. Get the swapped up. This is information. And there's no scarcity, guys. Helping others around you is helping yourself. In fact, some of you might need to group together and bunch together. This is the time for cooperation. You might not have all the resources. You might not have all the intel. I built a property business because I could find clients with a guy who was in the Midlands of the UK. I was with my South African accent, and he was a traditional Midlands-based, dyed-in-the-wool, rarely gone out of his own county man. But he could find the stock that we could get a yield on up in the Nottinghamshire stroke Derbyshire, etc. way, and I could find the clients. And we teamed together. Two unlikely people. The only thing that was common is that we spoke the same language, just about. He had sort of Southern Yorkshire type things. We built a multi-million pound business during the last property boom as a result of that. You don't know. Someone else on this channel might be your best support system. There are opportunities out there. Share it, like, get involved, start working together. Real estate is the game. So let me start with a little story that's coming straight from your friends in Zero Hedge. So first of all, to credit them with that, I will post the link, in fact, on the in the shoot. The AirBnB major push into the and the effect it's going to have in real estate, particularly stateside, but there will be smaller versions of this going down also in the rest of the market. So here comes the next crisis. Up to 30% of all mortgages will default in biggest waves of delinquencies. This is not the Airbnb article actually that I was looking to see. I'm busy scrambling around to get it after it resets. And I'm actually seeing the next story. Price reduced, foreclosure, bank owned. There will be an unprecedented event. The great financial crisis happened over a number of years. This is happening in a matter of months and a matter of weeks. Up to 30%. So that is almost a third, people, but for 3% more, it's almost a third, will default in the biggest wave of delinquencies in history. That is your headline. Wow. I mean, just think about that for a second, and you're going to start to get a real, real understanding of how intense things could be getting. And that's, once again, that's American. It won't necessarily be as extreme in a place like Germany, for example, where many people pay cash and outright, but there still will be property-based opportunities. The UK is kind of in between Europe and the US. There is a lot of very fluffy pricing in the UK. There are a lot of apartments on the Thames or within striking distance of the Thames that were selling for millions of pounds on nothing more than a basic two-bedder with a balcony. Wow, you know, this is not going to be at all easy for many people when this starts to kick off. So let me just see the article I was looking for. Airbnb. So here's the story. With regards to Airbnb, you have certain people that have a property of or two of their own that they've maybe just come into. Someone died, they inherited, and they let it out on Airbnb. That's your everyday host on Airbnb. He puts it out. He's covering the mortgage on it by the fact that he's renting it. But maybe it's in Vegas, so weekend people are coming for the weekend. You charge quite a high rate. The hotels are quite expensive, for example. And you can have it at 50, 60% occupancy, even lower. But in the high peaky weekends when big show on in town, you know, the second coming of Elvis is playing or Celine Dion or whoever's in town, you get to let and you pay your mortgage out of that. And now you get something called superhosts. These are people that have 20, 30 or 40 properties. So you get high number. These are people that probably get a little bit of a deal out of Airbnb, and they are providing lots of properties. And they have huge number of mortgages. So they have them on a lease rent back mortgage. In other words, this is like The Big Short when the character met the stripper with a four or five homes. A superhost is relying on the fact that they've got a portfolio of properties across America, and this is pretty American-centric type video, but there will be some instances of that in the UK, in Europe, in Spain particularly, I would imagine, and other parts where people are putting things out onto Airbnb. So suddenly they have, generally, even if you have a downer in Vegas because there's not much going on, they've got some cool places in Colorado, you know, it's skiing season, so they have a winter portfolio and a summer portfolio. It carries the across, you know, across all seasons, they balance out. Some are busier than others. Maybe some properties in Florida that are near the ocean, et cetera, et cetera. So they're letting these out, and the proceeds have been paying the mortgage, and the properties have been reflating back up since 2009. But now they might have been accumulating some of these properties and only started getting involved around about 15, 16, and they carried on buying into 2019 and 20, quite close to the reflation highs of property. In some cases and in some places, it's even gone beyond the highs of the subprime crisis. So since the 2008 crash in the 13 years stroke from there back up, 07, 08, they've even reflated beyond. They've now paid top dollar for these properties, and people were renting them and doing Airbnbs, and now we have lockdown. Now, 50% of the planet is on complete lockdown, and particularly the Western. It's America, it's Europe, it's the UK. 100% of the West virtually is on lockdown, and that's not good. That's not at all good. So what happens to your Airbnb portfolio, where you suddenly go to zero revenue? And let's be frank, people stopped traveling long before lockdown. So these guys are now in their second full month of absolutely no income at all on any property. It doesn't matter if you had a great beachfront Florida and you got a winter skiing Colorado property, they both empty. The one isn't carrying the other on a couple of good weekends at all. And your cash reserves are being absolutely eaten up. And let's also be frank, as I did yesterday, bailouts will be for corporations. The debt of forgiveness or government-based support is not going to be large for individuals. You saw what families got. One offering of $1,200 for a four-person family once. That's to say, yeah, we gave people as well this time to hide the billions that go into corporations where C-class executives were buying back their own stock not more than 6, 7, 8 weeks before that bailout and selling all their shares just prior to the pandemic collapse. And they are getting billions and being bought out and cheap loans at virtually 0.5%. And you're getting what? Your credit card at 25% for quick short-term cash flow needs and one $1,200 amount. How do you think that four-person family where the mom and dad have got an Airbnb business because they didn't fancy having a boss and driving the traffic are doing with their 40 properties, all locked down, empty, lights out, mortgage coming every single month on 40 properties. Hey, 20 properties, 10 properties. How do you think they're doing? Each payment, $2,000 a month coming in for an executive home that you can rent, you know, top end premier. This is what typically the people are doing. Yes, you might find a few tatty rentals, but the guys that are trying to do this properly, they want the sizzle. They want the short-term rental money to be good. You want to go, the people that all want to rent a Playboy mansion for a weekend with a fancy tub and a view. That's what's going on. Those mortgages are coming in, even with the very low rates in the States, $2,500 a shot. And you've got 10 of them. So you've got a $25,000, let's say. That's 10. That's low level super host. How do you think that guy's meeting his $25,000 with the whole rental market being shuttered for the last 2 months plus and for another month, probably a half after that, despite lockdowns eventually being lifted? They might be extended, but they may eventually be lifted. People aren't going to suddenly burst on holiday everywhere. Everyone's going the shit back to work because they are behind on their money. That's what's happening in this incredible story. 424 of you, I love that. Keep sharing it. You've helped bring people in. I appreciate that you're trying to scale this message out to other people. And I really value that you guys are sharing it and you've hit the likes. We've got almost 35% in likes. Okay, so this is one scenario that I've described to you here. By the way, let me just mention this as well. Non-farm payrolls. In literally an hour and a half, I will be going with my premium community and a few people that have just bought a pass ticket to come and join us for non-farm payrolls. That's the traditional markets for an hour and a half hour break, comfort break, knock your coffee back, get ready for crypto half. And the cryptos have come alive. We called Bitcoin long. We called, we preferred Ethereum slightly. So we went into Ethereum. We mentioned Bitcoin Cash and all of them could have a break. So we've got some interesting stuff to cover on crypto, a little stirring, but also a cautionary about what may still come when we have the second turn. We're going to go into that in detail and all the traditional market stuff. You can buy that. Look for the link from one of my guys being shared in the chat right now as to where you can go and buy that. You can even come for three non-farms with a special deal. That means 3 months in a row. You can hear exactly what we're looking at, how we're thinking, and the kind of discussions we have in our premium community. So thank you. That's been shared by the team. Anyway, so back to the real estate and how you guys can do what you need to do for real estate. So there's going to be distressed property out there, and it's going to be your bubble. The guys that have read the Rich Dad, Poor Dad book, and they decided to go the Airbnb route, and they absolutely hit the accelerator button. They leveraged up. They said, we're buying the damn dip. They chased in, built a bit of a portfolio, and now they are staring a pandemic. One of the great sayings is, get the goyim off the land. It comes from a book that you're not allowed to mention and not allowed to say, and apparently is meant to be a fraud. And I don't believe a word of it. And the key element is the game is to eventually have as much property in hedge funds that are mega landlords that are controlled by government or supported by government or funded by government that will do all the repo buying from the banks and to turn as many of us into tenants into our own homes. And you've got to watch for that. And they can't 100% kill everything. And they won't be able to 100% buy everything and be in all towns and all things. And there will be people that will be cash squeezed right now that will want to get the hell out of those properties. So if I'm sitting and I've got five Airbnbs and I were leveraging with profits each time, putting just 10% down and buying more property and getting so excited, I was growing this balance sheet and all these paper valuations on these properties were going up and I was now a paper millionaire and all of this, and boom, this happens and now I can't pay the mortgage. What happens to that paper value millionaire valuation? Through the floor right now. And then you're going to have a banker problem. Your money's going to be disappearing. That's what happens when debt doesn't get paid. You just have a blowout. Money just disappears. Whoosh, gone. And you end up with this physical asset. What is it worth now? Well, no one's got any money to buy for it, not enough people. You need to be the guy with cash and organized to do it. So if there's some of you that saw real estate playing a small role in reestablishing yourself and taking yourself up the wealth continuum, there will be opportunities coming and you need to be prepared. And I would also say, with family members that you trust that have different skill sets to you, you might have a sort of developer, decorator, handyman amongst you, someone who could project manage a development team and do a few of the things themselves, more than just a lick of paint. Most people can do that, but maybe a little bit of electrician in the family or a little bit of a fitter, joiner, handy with the wood, prepared to get ready. Believe you me, you're going to have time and you're going to have many of those people will be out of work. In fact, labor is going to be cheap. In fact, doing a fixer-upper is going to be real cheap. There's going to be a lot of people really keen to get that work if you're a payer and you have the cash to pay in an environment where so few don't. And this is the big opportunity that some of you should be preparing for right now. Need a swig of lemon water. Hold on. Drink your lemon water. Clears the kidneys. Takes heavy metals out of the system, makes your stomach alkali, and keeps you hydrated in these crazy times. Lukewarm is good as well. Kills your coronavirus. Oh. Let's see. I'm not too worried if I'm coroned out or not. Anyway, so back to the real estate. How are you guys doing anyway? Let me just check a few comments instead of having a never-ending monologue. Coming for your property, says John Fonseca. Australia is safe. Our 5G is bogus. Q isn't real. Trump isn't your friend. I agree. Trump isn't your friend. I think Q is a controlled hangout to have people think and hope that there's somebody on their team working for them behind the screens. There isn't, my friend. They want you to be passive and wishful. I even go so far. I've had some cranky thoughts. I don't know what's real or not, but that whole New Testament with Revelations, where don't worry, 7 years of tribulation and a Messiah will come and save you. Anything that is designed to keep you passive, waiting for divine intervention, cannot be your friend. Okay. My favorite religious saying is God helps those who help themselves. And I think that requires positive, proactive, take action. And if you're sitting there waiting for a Messiah on a chariot in beams of light to come and cast all your enemies into the sea, I'm saying then you are passive, and passive is your enemy. Active executive use of the center of your brain to help yourself, your family, and the community around you. Build allegiances. If you've got some legal paperwork to do in forging a partnership for your future property ventures that you're going to endeavor on, in an area where you know, buy a bicycle. I have a motorbike. Bicycles or motorbikes are great. You get to property view a whole bunch better. If you have to do a car, then have one with a panoramic roof or lots of open roof, sunroofs, so that you can look around and start becoming a pavement crawler. Just don't pick up any of those nearly ladies that want a little bit of money out of you, a bit of hard cash for dirty deeds done dirt cheap. Be a pavement crawler to view the areas that you would aspirationally like to live. Let me tell you, that lifts your mood immensely alone. How do I leverage into this district if that's what you want? You're in the States somewhere right now. You're in the UK somewhere right now. Go to the neighborhood up, where if you have children, the schools are better, whatever the case may be, there's more space, bigger plots, a good little garden for your dog to have a run. Maybe you want a swimming pool or you don't. I don't know. That's yours to fill in. Write your dreams, write your goals. Go pavement crawl once the lockdown is over, maybe even before. Break the law. Break the law. Do not comply. Okay, I'm kidding about that bit, but only just maybe. So anyway, that's what you kind of need to do. So there's going to be real opportunities presented, but you're going to need a combination of resources. You're going to need an identified solicitor or lawyer that will act for you for conveyancing that everyone is happy with. You're probably going to need some fix-up work maybe being done, unless you're buying per a place. So some ideas of contractors, what you can do and what others can do. You're going to need some resources. Now's the time. Say, go to your fathers and mothers that have a few shekels. Say, listen, don't leave me money at a random time when you die. Let's do something together now with your resources. Now's the time to take risks. I'm assuming some of you will be cash light. You may not have the resources for this. You haven't been sitting like me waiting for this moment. I'm the most patient vulture in this desert. I've been sitting on that cactus with the thorns digging into my feet and my eyes getting older and drier, getting gnarly and tan, sitting, watching that lone control structure person walking through the desert, getting drier and drier, waiting for his drink. I'm that patient vulture. We've all got to be patient vultures. But yeah, so go and form allegiances. You need resources. Be the plan maker. Be the energy if you don't have the cash. If you have the cash, get people that can execute. Start thinking about areas that you would want to be in. I'll tell you, when we were in property development, what's good for you. Locality to airports, particularly if you're going to do renting, and also if you're planning to live. Locality, the small, nifty, easy on and off airports are always nicer than the mega airports, by the way. So small, nifty airports take precedent. Higher education around you, university towns, and or college technicons. So here's the market sniper, quick shortlist to attractive areas. Affluence, sporting venues, university towns, and higher education. Higher education keeps a churn of fresh, young, new blood coming in, and all the support systems that serve them, nightclubs, concert venues, etc., etc., etc. Entertainment, critical. So if you were in South Africa, for example, Cape Town with Cape Town Airport, university town, big arts culture, plenty of LGBTIs that can come and make dirty love in your apartment, all sorts of mini communities, winemaking, tourism, a lot of things. If you're in America, Florida, proximity to Disneyland, Vegas, Colorado. Now, these are often more volatile property markets, so they are less stable, and that's good if you're buying at the bottom of the dip, because Vegas dropped hard. I think it dropped about 50, in some cases, maybe beyond 50% in the boom from 07 down to the lows of 08, 09. And you can expect the same. So there's more transient worker forces. So those will be higher beta. It's kind of like buying an altcoin versus a Bitcoin. But if you're buying the bottom of the bear market, great. Recognize that it's not going to be about cap appreciation. It has to wash its face. The key thing with property is cash flow. You've got to be able to get reasonable lettings. Who's going to be people? If you've got nursing and medical, where they're going to need lots of support staff, and you could have government that actually hires a whole block so that they can put sisters and nurses close to a hospital. So proximity to medical centers is also very, very useful. So these are the formulas that you need to think about. Also, for the people that are tenants, there's certain key parts and levels where what you buy for and what you get as yield is roundabout spot on. When you keep going more premium, you get into a different level of market and the yield is not so good. So I would say buy cash flow first, because when people start renting, they won't have the same amount of money. If you're in the States, typically that's around $1,000. So if you've got a rent that's at $950, generally there's a large pool of people that can do that, up to around $1,000. If you're asking $2,500, unless you're in central New York, when there's bankers and higher paying and lawyers and all of that, it's going to be a harder ask. So you've got to think about that. And then you get the super premium. Now, that's going to be a problem because they're not generally yielders, and people aren't going to be going on discretionary holidays. So no matter how cheap you can buy something that was super premium to become potentially an Airbnb let, you've got to bear in mind, what kind of occupancy are we going to have after this? This is not a V-shape recovery. Forget V. You know the L-shape recovery. It goes like this. Elevator crash. Bottom. L. Same as the bottom for a long time. And I would suggest that 2007 and 8 was more L than V, but it kind of had a slight, eventually, a little bit of an up thing. They did so much QE, so there was distortion in the QE. They devalued the dollar so that L had a little bit of, the lower leg of the L had a little bit of incline. I would suggest you're going to be closer to that again. Only the difference in this L is you're going to think you've hit the ground on the down leg. You're going to go sideways for a while and you're going to think, damn, that was terrible. It's goddamn awful. And then there's going to be another leg down to a new low L. And this is what you've got to bear in mind. You've got to bid like a bastard. You've got to put in 10 offers and be prepared for every single one to fail. If you don't submit that offer and say there's no way they're taking that offer, you haven't tried hard enough. You have to bid like a bastard because you've got to work on the fact that you're buying the first low, not the second low, and somebody else is going to have you over a barrel and you could be in trouble if your cash flow is wrong. So you've got to play this right. But the only game is risk in these times, not hunkering down. Actually, those that hunker down get whittled away. You know, it's kind of like you're going to be overrun by the Hun. Do you stand up and fight and organize and maybe try to get a little point of advantage where you actually break through their lines and you run through, or do you just hide and hold down? Imagine the Hun are charging and everyone's just cowering like this. You're going to get slain on the ground, man, woman, and child. So you've got to decide. I'm going to take risk at times of great risk because that's the way you come out. It's the ballsy things to do. I come alive in these moments, man. This is the time to be alive. This is where fortunes are made quickly. And you should be very, very conscious of that. So that is where I'm taking you on real estate. That's 508 of you and 219 likes. That's almost 40%. Thank you so much. Hit me up with a like. Hit me up with a share. You have family members, friends, and buddies that all should be thinking about this. They can watch this later in the day. It will still be up. It doesn't have to be live. It'll be recorded. You might need to talk to them. You might need to call a counsel. In the same way you do so in your brain, as I referred, is about our mindset component in our trading course that applies in life of your leader, warrior, sage. And you have to bring all that board together. In the same way, you might be the warrior that gives courage to others. You might need the smart guy in property who will be the leader on the property. You might need the capital provider, and you might need the empathizer that makes sure that you do everything with good energy and good flow, that's friendly for future tenants, that's and all the relationships are working well together. So you are both all those things in your own mind as yourself, and you will need to be talk out of one of those avatars in a group of people. Pull the resources together of the other people. Identify who they are. This is the game of mindset. These are your opportunities. And this can supplement your trading if you choose to trade, or your investment. Remember, HVF method, what we do is great for investment. If you only want to make one decision a year, make one big decision a year and invest. And, you know, I'm telling you, don't be in stocks. Not in this rally. It's going to get slammed again, in my opinion. And I am still short, HYG. So as an investor, I'm accumulating on dips, the gold and the silver. I'm watching crypto. I have crypto, and I will be buying real estate potentially when those things are time. So good, good, good. So we've been live for 35 minutes. It tells me 511 of you are here, 251, virtually 50%. So let's ask. I sold in the Bay Area in December, cashed out high end, says John Francesca. Well done. That sounds like a good timely cash out. Knowing the difference, wow, people, the difference between buying at a mega bloodbath low and selling close to a high in real estate and doing the absolute corollary, chasing in FOMO near a high, buying in 19 or 20 and being forced out at the bottom. Is such a difference in wealth, particularly in that one big transactions that you do. You know, you can overpay for a burger and Coke. That's not going to kill you. Don't overpay at the wrong time for property and then be a forced seller out. If your entries matter, we talk so much about this in trading, and it's part not just of a mindset, but why we always seek to be early. So we were early on oil compared to everybody else. We were early on oil, miles before the guys, it's going to fall. And we already had our shorts on. And then we got out. We got out when we had targets. PAA, we got out. Tullo, we got out. And then I actually released the YouTube and said, guys, it's a crowded trade, this short trade. And I'm looking at it technically. It's going to get a bump. It's going to get a bump. Oil is going to get a bump. Somewhere Russia, Putin or Trump, it's going to involve America, Saudi or Russia, is going to say or do something, and you're going to get a spike up. You're going to get a movement up in oil, and the ruble is going to calm back down again. And we got out of our longs on the ruble. You've got to be early to get out. And that happened. Do you know how those shorts, that short squeeze on oil? Let me just get that chart up from yesterday. It happened on yesterday's live stream, man. You can't make the stuff up. I did the YouTube a day ago before. You've got to get your timing right. You've got to get the timing right. Entry levels matter, and it doesn't change for freaking property. It's bigger for most people. It's your single biggest investment that you make in your lifetime. Do you think it matters what you pay and how you get out? You set a high watermark that's way too high. You sit in the red, you overpay, and if anything goes wrong and you have to get out, you've got red equity to eat. It's bankruptcy for many people. It's credit score down the drain. Not that I think credit scores are a good thing, but nonetheless, as a debt-free person, I don't want to have some bastard economic cycle eat all that I've saved on that small escalator, saving those small amounts and compounding them for so long, eaten in one bad decision in timing. This is how you invest. This is how you trade. Entries matter. You've got to get as close to that bottom as possible. We call that falling wedge. I said we're at $23 now here on the Brent crude. We've made our third impulse inside this wedge. We're going to break out. It broke out slowly. It returned, moved to our funnel. I'm looking at it right now. Small dip there, mega spike. That thing shot to 34. How many people that were in the crowded short trade on oil? Still patting themselves on the back saying, yeah, I knew oil would be a short. Well, guys, bam, it's sitting at $30. It was 23. It was 23 a day or so ago. That's $7 on 23. You're talking almost 30% there. Incineration. How did we do it? You can do it too. The free links are below. We have a complete course and program helping and discussing why these things are the way they are. We aren't always going to be right. We sleep. We miss a shot. Guess what? You don't even have to execute 100%. Most people are absolutely random and reactionary. They chase cars like dogs. They're momentum chasers. If it's going up, they chase it. The oil's along. If it's going down and it went down and the news all said it's down, hey, oil's a short, chase into the oil short trade. Most people are momentum chasers, both in investment and in trading. This changes your life in terms of every macro financial decision you make. Can you time? Can you time the market? Do you know if you bought at the top of the market and got out at the bottom, you would still be underwater from the last mega bear cycle from 1968. It's that bad. It's that bad when you look, take inflation into account. If you bought at the lows and you went to the highs, if you got the best 10 days in the stock market and you missed the best 10 days each year, the difference is unbelievable. It's unbelievable. It's absolutely unbelievable. It's the same as the number I give you out of the money book. If you double a dollar 20 years in a row, you end up with more than a million. If you pay 30% tax or you get out at the 30% down each year instead of doubling it and you have 30% off. So instead of making $2, you take your dollar to $1.70 and then you double the 170. Do you know what you get after the 20 years? Have a guess. Answers in the comment. Where do you think you end? You get over a million if you double it. If you get out 30% lower each time because you don't know how to time, you don't know when to get out, you don't have targets in your investments and your trading, you don't recognize things, all of these things matter in real estate and in everything, you only get to 22,000. Taking back 13, eating 30% down each time at the end, which is like paying a tax or getting your timing wrong in a market, doesn't matter how you bleed out that 30% every time, instead of getting you to a million, it compound interest over 20 years, the compounding effect sees you make 22,000. There's a huge difference between 22,000 and $1 million. And these small differences are where traders, investors, real estate investors, market traders, people that are using it are giving the game away and losing out. So I can't hammer this message home hard enough. You know, hear me now. There will be opportunities. Where you buy matters. How hard you buy matters. And there are banks, and they're going to have to show that not just government entities buy up all the properties. So you will get an opportunity to buy low, and you have to bid like a bastard. You don't want to think about the crying family that have to sell out and downgrade to poxy little flat or a caravan in a bad area. Unfortunately, that's not something you created. You've got to bid like a bastard. You've got to buy cheap to secure that home. The government will be doing it dispassionately. You have to become hard, and you've got to look after yourself and the people you are working with. The others did not prepare. They did not use the 13 years. They did not organize. They made a mistake. They will go away and they will learn. You didn't shoot them in the head. Take the move to make sure you get a good entry price. Okay, some comments. Rashida Bucha, America Trump's change. Don't understand. This fake virus really highlighted the population that was living paycheck to paycheck. Very good point. So many people, cash flow, they do not have more than a couple of months carry. If the salary doesn't come in, they do not have more than a couple of months carry. They spend their entire paycheck in payments on flat screen TV, car payments, house payments, and everything else. Know what you're paying. Never say, what's my payment? As I've often joked, we've had like cars on virtually 7-year deals where you're buying not even 100% of the vehicle. That's how they get $85,000 out of you of hard, fresh cash for a truck, which is actually old tech, guzzles loads of fuel, is super, super heavy. What? So that you look like a new age cowboy. You buy these things if you really want one secondhand for $8,000 in a knockdown market when they're sitting with an airport full of them that they've had to repo from people that couldn't make their payments. If you really want one, that's how you buy one. But I'm not a fan of buying depreciating assets. But, you know, if you've got enough cash and you bought something good and it'll cheer you up and keep you emotionally well, then do it. How do we know the property bottom, Francis? Are there charts? Are there charts? There's charts for absolutely everything. So in the UK, they have the Halifax Nationwide Price Index. I've done entire Excel sheets where I've valued property in terms of gold ounces. I've taken the gold price through all those areas. And in the past, long gone past, you could buy an average UK home for 1 ounce of gold. And we diverged to such a degree from that. And that was the financialization of everything. That is the cycle. It's not, oh, that was a bad measure back then. We will return to that measure. You'll get an average home for a gold ounce, I think, quite potentially. And that will tell you how high gold might need to go. You know, you might be looking at it at $100,000. I think there's a real chance. I did the chart each time. Bigger financializations, bigger, more volatility, higher overvaluations of property in gold ounces, bigger swings up, and then bigger smashdowns. And I thought, wow, the next time, it's not beyond the realms of possibility that actually a single ounce of gold could get you back in as part of that. Jason Williams, UK property is going to collapse big time. In the end, there will be 60% evictions, business and rentals. Track your own markets, do your own homework. So in the US, you have the Case-Shiller property price index, and they have charts for it. Go and chart it and go and download the data. I've taken that data, downloaded it, put it in an Excel sheet, got historical gold data. You can download an Excel with historical gold data. I've got the charts. I've done the work. Just do it for yourself. How low might he go? And you can see for yourself and you can generate a chart. A student of history, one of my clients has given 3 months three rent on all their commercial and resi stock and had to furlough their staff as a result. Yep, that is Olivier with the bear with the LGBT flag. He says, a student of history, he's had to cull his staff because he's just not getting the income. Now, I won't say to you these pandemics won't happen again. If you're going rental landlord full approach, recognize what's just happened. I think they find it damn useful to lock us all in our homes and turn us into prisoners in our homes. It's too useful for it not to happen again. That's where I'm at. So make sure you buy hard and well, and make sure you build up cash resources that you could sit through 3 months. So furlong means reduce time. I think I understand what furlong means. I should actually check it. It usually means reduced wages, reduced time. Let me just double check it. They use it a lot in the US, furlong. I think it's kind of put on suspension. Not a measure of distance. It's furlong staff. Furlong is a temporary leave of employees due to special needs. So it's like unpaid leave, we would call it. These involuntary furloughs may be short or long term. So yeah, it's kind of unpaid leave. I sold my house just before Christmas 2019, moved into rented accommodation. I knew this crash was coming. That is good timing, Perla Mom's Find. Well done, Perla Mom's Find. You took action, you made a decision, you sold the top. Now buy the bottom. Okay, get your seeds now. In future, there will be gold. Yeah, seeds, self-reliance is very good. Buying, getting as much of your own food is very good. You can barter. And that's a non-financial transaction. Will property tax liens be an opportunity? So here's the negatives for, and then I'm going to finish this loom. I'm going to tell you the negatives. First of all, I've already mentioned one. One of the negatives, if you leverage into an investment property portfolio, is that you have further, the control structure comes at you again with lockdowns, where people will officially not be able to pay their rents. I doubt this is the last time we experience this. I truly do. But I hope that they don't intend to do it too often but I doubt it's the last time. So I think you would have to plan for this. I think most of it will happen now-ish, though. They're going to need to get an economy going because they don't get any tax revenue when they do this, but it allows them to get up to all sorts of other tricks while we're all locked away in our little home jails. The other problem with it, so getting the goyim off the land is quite clearly a strategy in my view. I don't think it's an accidental that that appeared in the protocols. And I think the goal of turning you into a tenant into your own home is quite a real one. How will they punish those that remain that have property? Well, I've referred to wealth taxes, property taxes. The problem with the property is you can't stick it in your pocket and fly to another country with it. It's there, it's registered, title deed, everything. So they can come and get it. Non-farm payrolls, guys, don't forget it. I've been told to remind you, it's below in the link. You can come and join us. You might enjoy it. Crypto will be the second session, traditional markets, all of that. Okay, so anyway, so what I'm saying to you is you've got to watch for taxes that might come down the pipeline. So you've got to recognize and allow for. If they have a choice between buying an 8-unit property portfolio with a group of friends that you put down 40% of the money and the banks will come to the party with 60, because they will still need to do lending. They will still need to see that they are doing lending, not just to corporates and just there to serve corporates, and versus buying 10, but that's every penny you've got. I'd prefer to have the cash reserve, thank you, and 8. And that's the key thing. So that'll cover you for 3 months of lockdown. That'll cover you potentially for the situation of a wealth tax on your portfolio. Landlords could be hit really, really hard. Okay, great. So 574 of you, that's awesome. All interested in whether they can time the property market. By the way, you don't have to have all the money yourself. I know that some of you here don't. I know that some of you do, but get the group together of people you would like to work with. How motivated are you to see the opportunity that is being presented? Francis, look up the UK government coronavirus job retention scheme, CJRS, for explanation of furloughed workers in UK. Yep, thank you. I may do, I may not. Docus and Domain. Hi, Francis. Thanks for all you do. And by any chance, have a time frame in mind for deflation and then hyperflation to play out. So everyone asks, what's the time frame? We are in technical analysis. We've had the smackdown. We're in the bear flag rising wedge rally where there's all this money being pumped and all of this, the first attempt to stop the great capitulation. We need the next leg to the downside. This is why I say fear may reassert again. The stock market may sell off again. By the way, my HYG trade, I was looking at debt. Lots of debt will be bought, but junk debt is unlikely to be. So that's why I think the really bad subprime debt of corporate high yield junk debt is not the kind that is going to be easily justified to be bought. Of known bad quality. It will not be politically well appreciated. So when's the next leg? And it's coming. I can't tell you when the next leg down will be. It'll be another crisis. We're going to be in a very unlucky period. Lots of cleaning out of skeletons. Another crisis that is needed to be had will be had. And there will be drama and all sundry. Okay, so in exactly an hour, I'll be going for my non-farm and kicking it off on traditional markets where we'll look at the charts and talk further. So I'm going to be no more than 5-10 minutes here. I'll look at two or three more questions. I ask you for a final share. I thank you for the 303 likes and 584 of you on there. And I truly appreciate you. We'll see some of you on for the non-farm in a few minutes. Email me, Francis. I'm sorry, I don't have the bandwidth to email you. But you're welcome to go to our website and make whatever contacts and my people will deal with it. You will soon know when you are at the bottom in the housing market. The news will be terrible. There will be mad panic. The whole fear-mongering thing will be at all-time highs. And every time, what you need to do is switch your polar extractor on. So when people are giving you good news, suspect that it's probably not true. Control structure, that is, particularly. And be cautious. When you're getting nothing but the bad news, suspect, in fact, that it's true and feel good about it because the end is coming. because we've got to go, we've got to hit the bottom. You know, it's the laws of gravity. This is on a bungee cord that's got a snap. It's already fallen. It's on a little bit of a rebound bounce after they've thrown usual paper into the air, but it's not curing this. Everyone is so tired. It's always the same tool, no matter how many they talk of tools. As I said last time, the control structure give themselves away. The war on, that's a control structure purple. We have tools. You know, that's a central banking cartel. It's Draghi, it's whatever. All the same language. They self-identify. You need to just listen. And the tool is the same. And everybody knows that. The smart people all know that. So it's not going to have the same effect. You can just go more of a shit, throw more of a shit tool at it. All it does is, you know, they've got to implement this. Who's getting the money? We're not feeling it. Did you get any of the 6 trillion? Anyone here get any of the 6 trillion? Put your hand up. Not hitting me. It's not had any material effect. You know, some big corporate like Boeing might survive and its military industrial complex contribution may continue. But did you get any of that? No. Okay. Any physical silver out there? Will it break $15 up? Some folk battling to get precious metals. I haven't tried recently. I'm using Bullion Vault. That's the electronic version, which is not the same as getting physical. I encourage physical, but I have to also bear in mind where I'm based and where I'm putting it. Nope, still paying tax. All those pedos in the Vatican, says somebody. Boeing denied the stimulus, says Tristan Morales. That's good news if it's true. I haven't stayed up to date with it. I'm just using it as an example. It's not necessarily specifically accurate. I have a shop in New Zealand. I got $8,000, says iBallistic Cat. Well, good man. Don't you think there will be an opportunity buying Boeing stock? No, I don't want to buy anything that needs support. It's saying this is a defunct. They will bail it out. It won't go bust. But this is not a viable. I mean, it's like buying a bust bank. Why would you want to buy bust businesses in stocks? Guys, there's a tendency in newbies and even intermediates. You want to think you're buying the lows of a stock. The things that are collapsing for a reason. They were overvalued. This is not, oh, everyone has a penny stock fantasy. I paid for pennies and they went back to pounds. I mean, look at the charts of Barclays and Deutsche Bank at the lows of 2008. Do you regret not buying those lows? Do you want to see where they are now? And that's with everything that was thrown on them. Why not buy a good business, a good investment? You know, rather than a proven crap one that's being kept alive on an artificial heart machine. This could be the debt jubilee. Well, it gets broken up and pieces are spread and new corporation names are formed and the government own these corporations. This could be the period of debt jubilee. It may not be called Boeing anymore. It may get a new name. I mean, the 737 Max was a disaster. It's a people killer. These are people that are paid to fly people around in the air. And they're killing people. The doors are blowing off or whatever is happening. Buy from what they have, not what you want. iBallistic says his 8,000 will cover him for 3 months, live and pay mortgage. Yeah, you may need more than 3 months, but keep doing what you're doing. If you don't physically own your metals, then you don't own it. Generally, I agree with that. There's practical issues with it. Sometimes you need to have some e-gold and some physical. I do a mix. Pay the premiums now. I agree with that, the Matt Savage show. Pay the premiums. Do whatever you need to if you cash, get the gold. The premiums look big now. If you can get delivery, take them. Take it. Take it out the system and hide it well. Good morning from Canada, Rami. Hey, how are you, Rami? El Magrabi. Rami El Magrabi. I like that. Good sound to it. Yeah, the value is in the collateral casualties, not the rotting ones. Okay, BTC seemed to have a good pullback. Yes, I think it'll have a little dip back. I think it's in a slow motion move up to the levels we've indicated. You can get more on that on our non-farm on the other side of this. Okay, I'm sat at home and furloughed worker getting up to 2.5K max, 80% of salary paid by the UK government. This will be for 3 months. Saving my employer while no work going on. Johnny, I'm glad you're getting something. But remember, it ends. And then you have a destroyed economy to go back to and a job and a corporation that is in bad shape. And how you go from there is the big question. This is the time. You need to use these 3 months in terms of plans in how do you go forward out of this mess. And there are opportunities in the drama. So remember, guys, the quality of your life is dictated by the quality of the questions you ask yourself. How does this serve me is the only question you should be asking. How does all this crap and all this destruction serve me? And that is the question you write at the top of your page. So I want the serious amongst you after this video to get a page out, sit down with a pen and write at the top of that page, how does everything that I am seeing going down serve me? And I want you to write 10 points of things that you can do with your free time while you're sitting furlong, getting paid £2,500, 80% of your wage, which is the maximum, and what you will do to come out of the situation better than you were before. And let me tell you, there are real answers to that, plenty of them, and the answers lie within you. And you need to go into your boardroom. You need to tap up all the key smart members, and we all have them. You've got to talk to your warrior who will give you courage. You've got to talk to your leader who's brave and will make the right key decisions. You've got to talk to your sage who is your wisdom, all-seeing, and knows you well, better than anyone else, and can see what's happening around. There is the intellect. And then you talk to your empath, your good Samaritan, and you decide and you say, here's what my board, the executive board of my mind, has decided I need to do to take myself forward with all the amazing opportunities that are being vomited up in front of me. And while other panic like headless chickens, the smart, the bold, and the people that can contain their own mindset that are not externally affected by the drama that is being inflicted on those around them, that are not giving the reaction that the problem was designed to create, undermine the control structure by responding with excitement, possibility, opportunity, and real estate is one place where you may do it. Becoming a great trader is another, but it's not for everyone. Becoming a good quality investor that makes one decent decision a year is another, and we can help you with both. And other, not involving me, I don't mean to sell, other, you will fill out those 10 points, then go execute. And you have 3 clean months ahead of you, potentially, some of you salaried, to do it. And that is my final message. And I wish you all well. I'll see those that want to join us, $195 for one non-farm, $397 for three. That means 3 months of check-ins with me during the biggest and most intriguing times, guys. During the biggest and most intriguing times. And I've had 329 likes. I really appreciate that. Share this video, even post the recording will be here. I need to go get ready to talk to my amazing premium community of smart, self-actualizing people who see the opportunity here, who I'm eternally grateful for. And we will be talking about the traditional markets in all the opportunities from FX, emergings, equities, indices, and particularly gold and silver. And then we'll have a half hour lunch break, comfort break, and then we'll be back with the cryptos as well, where there's some interesting developments. If you want to be part of that, jump right in. Otherwise, thank you, share, and I appreciate you all, and play safe, and do not give the control structure the reaction they need. Respond from leadership. Many of you are male, you're heads of your family. Your wife needs to feel your comfort. Your children needs to feel your confidence. There's an energy in the house of fear. There is an energy of restriction. You are coming in there and you are showing leadership. You are the master of your own destiny. You are the captain of your ship. Look after those that you are responsible for. To the single mums and the other women that are on here, go and be the matriarchs that you are born to be. Be the power of the family. Be the spine of the family. Give out love and give direction. You can do it too. Thank you. Goodbye. I salute you all.